that leaves the Congolese in extreme poverty, according to the way World Bank classifies extreme poverty. Up to 70% of the population live on less than $2 a day. If you look at the United Nations Human Development Index, of the 180 plus countries or so that they document, Congo is found consistently near the bottom. Now, this is in the space of arguably the richest, the most blessed country on the planet. Economists at Business Insider say that Congo is estimated to have $24 trillion worth of natural resources in its soil, right? The United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization says Congo has an agricultural capacity to feed over 1.2 billion people. That's more than the population of the entire African continent. That is equivalent to the expected increase in world population between now and 2050. So natural resources, agriculture. And then this space is the second lung of the world, behind the Amazon. It's vital in our fight against climate change. It has the agriculture, the hydro capacity, should one want to go down that path, to provide electricity for the entire African continent, some leftover Southern Europe, and the Middle East. So we're talking about a space that is tremendously wealthy, yet the people are kept in dire poverty, basically living from hand to mouth, getting up every day, and the number one thing on the overwhelming majority of people is finding a way to survive and food to eat. And that's, as I've shared with you, by design and not by accident. So